This is Calle Gamarra, a bustling shopping district in downtown Lima. Peru has a thriving industry of cotton and alpaca, and that's helped power a retail boom here. An estimated 15,000 businesses are based in this district alone, many of whom make clothes for high-end Western companies. Others export to other countries in Latin America. The area really tells the story of Peru's growth explosion. Just 10 years ago, Gamarra was a rundown area well known for crime. Today, it's secure. You see people everywhere, and glass towers, like the one behind me, are being built all over the area. In that time, Peru nearly doubled its economy while maintaining stable inflation. It has also signed a series of landmark free trade agreements.
For 14 consecutive years, Peru has been growing more than 6.5%. And we also have seen that the poverty rate has fallen.
Like other parts of Latin America, Peru benefited greatly from China's rapid economic expansion and its need for raw materials. Peru is one of the largest producers of copper and zinc in the world, and mining accounts for 60% of its exports. Money poured into the stock exchange, sending shares spiraling by more than 1,000% over 10 years. Meanwhile, record foreign direct investment actually created problems for Peru. Its currency, the sol, soared, raising fears that exporters could be hurt. Meanwhile, slowing growth in China has dampened demand for its commodities.
If we're seeing a slowing growth in China, that can have negative impact on economies in Latin America that rely very much on natural resources and commodity export. That's also a reason why these countries have no to diversify their economies.